channel. I shared some of my most embarrassing moments, I think it was last year. And there's more of them. Since it was so mortifying the first time around, I thought, why not? Let's just throw it all out there. So here I am with my most embarrassing moments, part two. Back in my dance days, my dance school took part in a festival every year in, I believe, springtime. My tap class was doing a really cool dance to Top Hat, White Tie, and Tails from the movie Top Hat. It was sung by Fred Astaire. My head was too small for the hat. The hat was too big for my head. Throughout the dance, my hat kept slipping over my eyes. And as a dancer, you're taught that no matter what goes wrong, on with the show. So I tried to not fix it. I can't remember if I actually touched it or not, but basically I was trying to find ways to see because it was literally starting to affect my vision. I suddenly noticed this young couple in the front row and realized that they were laughing at me. You might think, oh, maybe they were laughing at something else. No, it was pretty obvious. Small stage, small crowd, it's really easy to tell what's going on. That's just how it was. And they laughed at me throughout the entire dance, and that was all that happened. But I don't know, that was just really mortifying for me. Okay, well, I thought that would be an easy place to start, but no, that's kind of sad. Oops. Ugh. Let's move on to a water park story. Those are fun. So, me and my best friend Gabby, we were at a water park. I'm sure you've heard of a lazy river. In front of the lazy river was a beach area. There was no sand, but it was just like, you know, that much of water, and you could, you know, lay down in cool water, but still, you know, tan or just lay there and relax. So we were laying there tanning, you know, really cool sunglasses on, and she suddenly had to use the restroom. I didn't think anything of it, so I was like, oh, sure, I'll be fine. I'll wait here for you. You know when you feel shadows over you? I can kind of feel the sun being blocked. I look up and there's these two guys that I know. I won't say I was in love with either of them, but they were good looking, okay? I'd like to say I was cool, calm, and collected. I tried on the outside, but on the inside, it was wall to wall panic. I was like, help. And of course, at that point, I am super upset at Gabby for having to use the bathroom. I'm like, how could you leave me? So they're standing over me and they just kind of do their cool guy thing, like, so. At this point, I'm like, this is kind of weird. They're standing, I'm laying down. Do I sit up? I kind of like half sat, took off my shades, and it's like, hey. They just basically were like, what's up? What you up to? You know, just chilling, acting normal, you know. I can't even remember all I said. Like, for all I know, I didn't even speak English. But they're like, oh, that's cool. That's cool. I'm just like, yeah, it's great. Love water parks. I don't know. That's it. Pretty much the gist of the conversation. Nothing deep or philosophical. They're like, well, see you around. Yeah, that'd be great. No, it wouldn't. Walk away, all cool, you know, still in their shades, blah, blah. And I'm like, oh my god. Gabby walks back, and I'm like, how could you? How could you leave me? And she's like, huh? What are you talking about? I tell her what happens, and she's like, oh my god, what did you do? And I was like, I don't know. I blacked out. I don't remember. I know it sounds really stupid, but as a girl at that age, at a water park, already a lot of issues going through your head. Two guys that are really good looking come up to you while you're tanning, and it's just like all etiquette, all sense of the English language, all control. No self-control whatsoever. Nothing technically embarrassing happened, but it stuck in my mind to the point where I'm like, did something embarrassing happen and I don't even remember? Because why else would I remember something so dumb and trivial? Like, I'm more than sure that they could tell how nervous I was. Fun times. Middle school, am I right? Ugh. How about a just good old-fashioned retail story? This actually has nothing to do with the customer. At my current job, in our old store, the store was messy, so I was walking around cleaning. One of the display signs, it kind of had sharp edges, and I guess it caught on the zipper of my pants. Can you see where this is going? How? A sign, an inanimate object, unzipped my pants. Why is this my life? I'm quickly tugging my shirt down as far as it will go, and I'm like, I have to go to the back real quick. Go back, zip up my pants, come back out. I could have, like, either run into someone I, you know or into my boss. Like, thankfully, it was over and done with, but it was... This stuff happens all the time. All the time. You know how paranoid I am now because of things like that? At work, I'm constantly checking my zipper, checking my top, checking everything. Class, we have come to the geography portion of this video. I want to make it clear that I was a very good student in high school. I passed geography. So you know maps, how they don't always have room at the top. So that cute little adorable state we know as Alaska is sometimes put at the bottom. And it's usually in a box. Well, I didn't realize that box meant that it's not actually there, it's just moved there so it's visible on the map. In a conversation with my family, Alaska came up and we were talking about where it is. I never really thought or said Alaska's in the south by Mexico. Somewhere in this conversation, I didn't necessarily state that it was by Mexico. I just sort of in a roundabout way talked about it, like questioning it. I just wasn't sure. I'm like, well, isn't it in that area down here? And my family, who does not hesitate to make fun of me, thanks guys, they asked me, did you ever question why a cold state would be in the south where hotter, warmer climates are? Wouldn't you think, why wouldn't it be up there with Canada? Where it's cold. Well, I had never really thought about it, okay? I just always saw it at the bottom. They have never let me live it down, ever. That was years ago. And I still hear about Alaska, and I'm like, I get it, funny. Thankfully, my sweet aunt heard the story, and she's like, no, I get how you could be confused about it. I totally get it. Thank you for understanding. My father and brother, still not understanding. Let it go. This is my final story. It's a babysitting story. Disclaimer. No kids have ever been harmed in my care. I am a capable babysitter. So, I'm babysitting my neighbor's kids, a brother and sister. I had babysat for them before, but at night. Since it was daytime, the mom told me that they could have popsicles and play outside with the dog. Everything's going fine, playing with the dog, having fun, popsicles. And then the sister, I can't remember if she had to use the restroom or she just wanted to wash her sticky hands. Sure, let's head inside and wash our hands, go to the bathroom, whatever. She turns the doorknob and nothing happens. Tries again, nothing happens. I'm trying not to think anything of it, but I'm like, here, let me try. Nothing happens. It is hot and humid and the kids are sticky from their popsicles and there's a dog. I know there's a front door and a garage door in the front. The sister is not like a preteen, but I trusted her enough to know about the front door and the garage. And she tells me that we can open the garage from the outside. And I'm hoping and praying that the door to the house is unlocked. We leave her little brother and the dog behind the gate and close it. And we're telling him, stay stay with the dog, okay? Don't move. We're gonna check the garage door. Staying calm so he won't panic. We get to the garage and she helps me open it and the door is locked. The door to the house. She tells me that she knows there's a spare key somewhere. I searched everywhere. I did everything but depot the plants altogether. Like, I searched the dirt above and under doors and mats and everywhere I could think of. To be honest, I can't remember if this happened before the garage got opened or after. In a split second, even though we were talking to him and encouraging him and keeping our eye on him, the little brother managed to open the gates. Now, I wasn't worried about him because there's plenty of space between him and the street, and I knew that he wouldn't run into the street or anything. What I was worried about was his companion. Remember who was with him? The dog. Do you know what the dog's name is? Dino. Do you know what I spent the next, I don't know, 5 to 10 minutes doing? Running around like a maniac screaming, "Dino! Dino! Come here! Dino! Get back in the backyard! Dino!" It was like an unaired episode of The Flintstones. The little brother was fine. He stayed put. He was obedient. He did his best to help with his little voice. "Dino! Dino! Come here, Dino!" Really just added to the chaos, but he was trying to help. The sister held open the gate while I was screaming and trying to shepherd this dog. It wasn't a big dog. It was a small dog. Worse. I was just praying that the dog would stay in sight because the absolute worst thing that could happen was losing the dog. Finally, I managed to get him in the gates. Like I said, I can't remember if this happened before or after the whole garage thing. All that got shut and locked. We got back in the backyard. No key, no door, and we're stuck outside. I knew at this point it was time to call the parents. I gathered my wits about me, and I made a very calm phone call explaining that the door was locked, and we tried to get inside through the front, and nothing was working. I had two hot, exhausted kids and a very naughty dog. We all sat under the shade and calmed down. And then I got them on the trampoline and just played some games to keep their minds occupied. It didn't take long for the parents to arrive. Of course, I had to tell the parents the rest of the story about the dog and all that. In the end, I was just kind of bracing myself for them to tell me, "Don't come over here ever again. Don't come around my kids." Surprise of all surprises, they apologized to me, telling me that the lock was faulty in some way, and it did that a lot. They commended me on being so level-headed and keeping everything under control. Nobody was hurt, and I ended up babysitting for them again. I can laugh about it now in some ways, but I took it seriously because I was in charge of someone's kids and a dog. And it was embarrassing to me because I never want anyone to think their kids are in danger with me, but it all worked out, and I am proud of myself for keeping a level head. You know, I can say that now after hearing from the parents, but at the time it was mortifying. I felt so bad. I hope you've enjoyed laughing at my expense. If you have any funny, crazy, mortifying stories to share, let's chat in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to hit that red button down below to subscribe and become a member of my YouTube family. Also, click the bell to turn on your notifications. I will see you in my next video. Bye!